Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of Cold Waters with our Soviet 1968 campaign. Our task is still to patrol the Greenland Sea and to hunt for convoys, for submarine forces, just to basically disrupt the enemy supply lines and to keep this area safe for our use. Now we just left Murmansk. And here is a convoy that we are going to hunt. It's moving towards the Greenland Sea, so I consider it an absolutely valid target. Come on. Oh, no, 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 no. Not you. Okay, where did the convoy go? I think I got them. We have a new sonar contact, bearing 321. We are at a depth of 183 meters at a speed of 20 knots. There is a moderate surface duct with a weak thermal layer of 54 meters. It's raining, but the seas are calm. That could be important.
Товарищ командир, новый акустический контакт. Пилинг 3, 2, 1. Внимание в отсеках! Объявляется режим тишина.
Yeah, we are picking up contacts. Let's start with Sierra 2.
Товарищ командир, новый акустический контакт. Пилинг 3, 1, 4.
Правильно.
Товарищ командир, потерян контакт. Последний пилинг 3, 2, 9. Сигнал затухает.
I think this is a burn-up as well.
Товарищ командир, докладываю гидроакустику. Sierra 3, опознан как эскорт.
This is a bunch of burn-ups?
Товарищ командир, докладываю гидроакустику. Sierra 1, опознан как эскорт.
This is indeed a bunch of burn-ups. I need to load other torpedoes. We have slowed down, so our sensors can operate at their maximum efficiency. However, I don't like to engage burn-ups here. Let's come up to a depth of 60 meters, just below the layer.
Есть, товарищ командир.
The enemy is near. Let's have a look if our targeting data is correct so far. So Sierra 1 is indeed a BALNAP, Sierra 3 is absolutely a BALNAP, and Sierra 2 is a BALNAP. I don't like this.
Товарищ командир, первый готов.
I thought we were engaging a convoy, but this.
Товарищ командир, потерян контакт. Последний пилинг 3, 1, 6. Сигнал затухает.
Maybe this is not a convoy that we intercepted, but maybe there was an ASW patrol incoming that went into towards us in our direction, and we ran into them. That's bad. So far, this is really bad. This is definitely an ASW group. First BALNAP is at a range of 7.4 kilometers, but this is already too close to use the missiles, so we are not going to use them. To be honest, I should try to evade them. Need to go deeper. My goal here can't be to sink them. To sink them all. This is an ASW patrol. My best option, in fact, is to just avoid them, if possible. Because they can certainly put a lot of pain on me. They are already having torpedoes in the water. And
there's
a Sierra 4, which is cavitating. Submarine in the area. No. Valiant. The Valiant in the water and he has launched against me. Yeah, we are not getting out of this without a fight. I don't think so. My problem right now is I could go active to immediately detect this Valiant, but that would make it damn easy for the Belknaps to pinpoint my position, and since they all have rocket-propelled torpedoes, they would be dropping them on my position in no time. So I can't do that. Okay, I will turn in. I'm going silent. The Belknap has slowed down and is listening. I don't know what the Sierra 5 is. It's not a submarine. It's an oil tanker. So sinking that actually is worthwhile. For now I still have to see what this Belknap is up to. Now there's one thing I could do. I could go active, detect the Valiant, shoot a torpedo at the Valiant, and then sprint away while this area is saturated with torpedoes. But my problem is really this Belknap here. It's way too close for comfort. And he's going very slow, he's just listening.
Командир, маневр выполнен. Идем заданным курсом.
We have completed our turn, that's good. And we are using the layer to hide as well as we can. The other warships are closing in as well. I don't like this. Just a small course change to keep myself pointed directly at the Belknap. This actually reduces my cross profile, so when he's pinging, he's getting a return only from, let's say, this amount of surface. If I was sideways onto him, he would get a return from all of this. So this is helping me a little bit. You can see the ships up on the surface. There's one Belknap.
Командир, маневр выполнен. Идем заданным курсом.
He turned around. I'm not sure what they're up to. Is he waiting for other Belknaps to arrive? Torpedo in the water. Who fired this torpedo? Was it the Valiant? If it was the Valiant, does the Valiant have wire-guided torpedoes? I don't know. If it was the Valiant and if this torpedo was wire-guided, then that would signify that they lost me. This Belknap is still pinging. And I'm a bit far away to effectively use the torpedo. He's speeding up as well. I will soon have a good position on the oil tanker, so that I can try to sink that one. I wouldn't mind that. That's a worthwhile target. ...78% solution. 4.9 kilometers to the Belknap, but he's steaming away. So my best bet might actually still be to try to get away. Let us try that. I have contact on the fleet oil tanker.
Командир, скорость хода 1-0.
If I shoot like this, there's a chance that I will hit it. It's too far away, almost 10 kilometers. This is too much time for him to simply change his course, and then I've wasted another torpedo. I have to wait for a better shot. For now, let's use some time compression. I think I'm in this Belknap's baffles. Yes, I am. So I'm trying to get out of here. That's still my plan. If that works, awesome. Contact on the Valiant, and he's pinging. God damn it. The Valiant knows where I am. I'm pretty sure of that. Go active. Do I have contact on the Valiant? Yeah, I do. Fire one. Turn this way. Make it a fast turn. No, 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 there's already a torpedo. Turn around. These are the airdrop torpedoes. Reload the tube.
Докладывает гидрокустик. Ложная цель, Белем 2, 9, 1.
Now, one thing is for sure, the Valiant has lost the wires, if he had any in the first place. I don't know if he has wires or not. I would have to look it up. There's a good chance that the torpedo will pick him up, though. And then I need to be ready to fire another one. The Valiant can go 29 knots, and I guess it is kind of nimble. That's the Valiant. Yeah, we'll most certainly need another torpedo fired at him in the general area. Another torpedo away. New contact 06, what the hell is that? Is it another submarine? I'm not yet sure what this is. Cargo. So this might in fact actually be the the supply convoy that we spotted. Who knows, but now the Valiant has another torpedo incoming for it. If this torpedo turns, now it turned left, of course it did. But there's another torpedo incoming. He will have a harder time evading two torpedoes. Now I need to know what's going on with the Belknaps. They must be steaming towards me. Yeah. Helicopter. I can hear a helicopter. I don't like that sound. Helicopter somewhere above. Let's turn a few degrees to make sure that the Valiant stays outside of our baffles. Come on, torpedo number two, hurry up a bit. You're too slow. One Belknap has turned around. I still think the best plan might be to try to get out of the area and not to sink everything. Sinking the Valiant will be nice, but I'd much rather alive and with a few more torpedoes for better targets than dead and having sunk a few Belknaps. So my torpedo number two should be going active any moment now. Let's actually continue our turn. Yeah, there's the other torpedo. Both are now in the area. Let's see if they can pick up the target. I need to reduce this Valiant's capabilities, so either I sink him or I seriously damage him. That would also be very welcome. Here we have a torpedo going for a noisemaker instead of for the target. Typical. Oh, oh, oh! Did you see that? This is awesome. One of the Belnaps has actually dropped a torpedo on the Valiant. Friendly fire. This Valiant is screwed. It's screwed by friendly fire. And one torpedo is about to go in. Yeah, this will be a hit. Oh, look at this. He's turning for all he's worth, but... What the hell? This did not just happen. Damn, that was unfair. Damn, I feel cheated now. I really do. And the torpedoes are going after some stupid noisemakers while the Valiant is speeding out of the area, and they're always turning in the wrong direction. My rotten luck. Damn! I almost had him. Almost. I cannot believe this. This is so stupid. And look at him. He's cavitating like crazy. He's producing so much noise and they are still all going for the damn countermeasures. Dear torpedoes, look up here. Here's a really big, juicy, noisy target. Okay. Now, it would be appreciated if they didn't both turn in the same direction. Yeah, one detonated. Okay, now at least one torpedo will pick up the target again. Coming in. But the submarine should drop another countermeasure right about now. Still, I have an incoming torpedo. And he might be in a position where the countermeasure can't affect him anymore. Yeah, exactly. This is a hit. Come on, this must be a hit. Oh, Jesus Christ. Come on. Come on. Yeah, there we go. That's one hit. And the friendly fire torpedo is coming around. And it's about to acquire the Valiant. There we go. And the Valiant has slowed down substantially. So this is a dead sub. It went for the noisemaker. It had the submarine in front of it. And it still went for the noisemaker. I need to concern myself with the Belnap, to be honest. Pretty soon, as well. For now, the Belnap is still steaming towards me at full speed. But that might change, and then he will have a better chance of picking me up. If I can let him close to 3 kilometers, then I have a really good hit chance on him. Ah, torpedo incoming. Yeah, there we go. Now surely this must be hit number 2. Of course. Of course, of course, of course. The torpedo ran out of steam just meters in front of that damn submarine. Wow. Okay, I need to come up. I cannot believe this. I really don't. This is so... Oh god. Now I have an incoming Bernab, who's already way too close. And the Valiant is pinging me again, so that means he will fire torpedoes. I will fire one right back as soon as I'm at a more appropriate depth. But I need to get to... to a depth above 108 meters to be able to fire one of these wake-homing torpedoes. Although this burn-up has come so close. Yeah, oh, same depth restriction, okay. I might actually fire this one. Come on. Belknap is only 2 kilometers away. This is basically point blank range. Okay, here we go. Wait, he's turning. He is turning. He's launching torpedoes as well. Let's see what he does. I can't really wait any longer. Fire. The Valiant is again speeding up. Let's go down. Upturn. My torpedo should acquire the target. Did I set it up in a circle search pattern, or is it going after the damn torpedo? What's happening right now? This is not the plan. There's always something going wrong. This is incredible. Did I really set up circle search? I set up a circle pattern, but, well, maybe I did? Come on, get up there. A little bit more speed. I need to sink this banner now that he's here. That's again typical for me to waste a whole bunch of torpedoes. I'm amazed that the Valiant can go at full speed again. Okay, this torpedo will acquire the burn-up's wake. So the burn-up is definitely in trouble. Yeah, there we go. I'm getting out of the way of this torpedo here. We are reloading another torpedo. Burner boss hit. But one torpedo doesn't seem to be enough to sink it. So we are preparing another one. Let's see what the burn-up does, how much it will slow down and everything. Yeah, let's just fire like... Let's just fire like this and the torpedo will spiral up to the surface. And then we'll go into a circle search pattern, where it should pick up the burn-up. Who is now counter-launching against me? Let's try to run underneath his torpedo. The torpedo is running for the countermeasure. That's fine. And my own torpedo should be running up for the burn-up. Yeah, there it comes. So the burn-up is screwed. He's getting hit squarely in his sonar array. So he's done for. And this torpedo... Well, I don't need to worry about that. I think I will indeed try to get out of the area now. This sinking wreck here is offering me an opportunity to do that. He's producing a lot of noise, which will mask my escape. So we are just booking it. We are out of here. Let's see if this works.
Командир, скорость хода 2, 5, узлов.
Waiting for the torpedoes to disappear and everything. Alright, and now we will turn to the south and go silent. Can we leave the combat area? No, there's vessels nearby. Okay, I'm not out of the danger yet. There actually might be a burner bearing down on me. Yeah. Well, my torpedoes are ready. Let's come up. This burn-up might be close. For now, my crew is estimating it at 3.7 kilometers. He might indeed be that close. We will have to see. The solution is firming up and we are still coming up to a depth where we can actually use the torpedoes. Still estimated at 3.6. Start the turn towards the target. Okay. We can now launch a torpedo once we have a good solution. I have no doubt that this burnup knows exactly where I am. So I find myself at a disadvantage, but not any longer. We have a good solution. We know his position. 3.5 kilometers and closing at a slow speed. No, actually 4 kilometers away. Okay. We will let him close for a bit. Playing chicken with a destroyer. That is what's this called. Keep closing. He launched. My turn? Yes, no. He's still launching more torpedoes. Yeah, now it's my turn. Torpedo on the way. Let's get out of the way of his torpedo. He's starting to turn and speeding up. The other burnup is incoming as well. Flank. Should stop to cavitate any moment. Yeah, there we go. I will get out of the way of his torpedoes, no problem. I'm fast enough for that. I hope I'm fast enough. But yeah, I think I am. What is my torpedo doing? It's coming up to the surface. It should acquire the target's weight. Yeah, he's not escaping this. Yeah, there we go. Torpedo has acquired the wake and will now hunt down the ship. I think it even already went into terminal guidance. This is looking good. Let's use the opportunity and get close. The burnup has issues. Torpedo issues. Incoming. There we go. Nice big hole in his side. Silent running. And preparing another torpedo. He is slowing down, I guess. Maybe not. Yeah, he is slowing down. Circle searching torpedo to the surface, coming up. He's again launching at me. Let's hope that my torpedo does its job. think this is my torpedo coming in.
Командир, майор Оплен, идем за верным курсом.
Yeah, but he's turning into the wrong direction. I should have set him up the other way around. I don't know if he will pick up the burn up. I think he will. I think it's close enough to pick it up. Yeah, it's going for the noisemaker. And the Belknap can't go super fast anymore, so this should be a guaranteed kill.
Товарищ командир, четвертый готов.
There's the target up there. With a torpedo coming up his tailpipe. This thing is sinking. But I have the third Belknap already incoming. Again, I'm wasting all my torpedoes on stupid warships. Now there seems to be another torpedo incoming towards the wreckage. Yeah, there it is. That's an enemy torpedo. Well, I hope he will manage to get to the wreck and not to me. Yeah, he's going for the wreckage. I'm fine with that. Put another hole into that stupid ship. Yeah, there we go. Oh, another torpedo. From there. This could be dangerous for me. Now this thing will sink and the torpedo might not be able to get the wreck and then go towards me. So this could get very interesting in a heartbeat. We'll see though. Oh yeah, the torpedo went straight past the wreckage. We'll see what happens now. Let me take a screenshot of this. That is too nice. What is the torpedo doing? It's now coming back around. And it's definitely in a position to pick me up. He's not doing it though. Okay. I have another Belknap incoming. Which I don't like. Belknap is coming in very fast, closing the distance. Now if it wasn't for this torpedo in my immediate vicinity, I would now speed up a little bit to get near this Belknap while it's still going at such a speed, because I suspect it will slow down once it reaches this area. Just have to go like this. I wonder where the Valiant went. And I will definitely try to sink the oil tank and the cargo ship once I've finished off this Belknap, because now that I did expend so much ordnance, I wanted to be worth something. Damn, look at this, I only have 8 torpedoes remaining. I will again expend half my torpedo load. Torpedo detonated. Belknap still incoming. Okay. Come up.
Занять глубину. 7-6 метров. Есть, товарищ командир.
I need to be in a good position to fire the wake-homing torpedo. Slowing down. I think he's slowing down. We are in a position to launch. And we are launching like... Torpedo out on the Belknap from short range. He's launching as well. He's counter launching. Speed up. His counter launch is a bit weird though. He has no idea where I am. This is good. And my torpedo should have no issues picking up his wake. Let's actually have a look. Yeah, there we go. Torpedo's already on terminal guidance. So another Belknap is about to eat it. Come around this way. Prepare another torpedo shot. Belknap got hit. We are cavitating, doesn't matter very much, but still, let's go deeper. I need the speed to close in. I'm absolutely in his baffles, so he has no idea where I am. And he's slowing down because of the hit. I think we might have actually hit... Now we hit in the side. I would really much prefer a hit into the screws. That would slow him down for good. But this is okay. Need to close the distance just a little bit to increase my hit chance. And while I am in his baffles, I can use the opportunity to do that safely. He's slowing down a lot. Wow. I'm closing in fast. Yeah, closing in very fast. Let's use a little bit of time compression here. I got pinged by the Valiant. It's fine though. Still in the Belknap's baffles. Okay. Slowing down.
Товарищ командир, потерян контакт. Последний пилинг 2-7-7. Сигнал затухает.
Ben, I'm still going slow. And I can set up a really nice rear shot here.
Командир, маневр выполнен. Идем заданным курсом.
Четвертый, при!
Let's go towards the Valiant.
Выполняем маневр, товарищ командир.
Возобновлен контакт, пилинг 2-7-9. Докладывает гидроакустик. Ложная цель, пилинг 2-0-0.
My torpedo is going for the surface. That's another ship down. Now for the Valiant. Do we have a good targeting solution on it? Not yet. Let me go up to periscope depth. I need to fire on these... on the cargo ship and on the oil tanker before they are completely gone. So we might have to use our radar.
Товарищ командир, потерян контакт. Последний пилинг 2-8-2. Сигнал затухает.
Let us actually go a little bit faster. Reload another torpedo. I wouldn't mind getting this Valiant.
Командир, скорость хода 1-0-0.
Coming up. With a little bit of time compression here. Okay. Stop cavitating. We have cavitated for a little bit. But that's fine. This is good. Your cargo is at 3-2-8. Targets. Where's the oil tanker? Where is the oil tanker? The oil tanker must be a little bit faster. Is this cargo coming straight for me? Yes, yes it is. Raise the radar mast. Can I get a fix on the oil tanker? Or will I have to content myself with the US cargo? Any helicopters in the area? No, not really. 328 was this target's bearing. No contact on the other ship. Yeah, that's fine. Take out the US cargo then.
Возобновлен контакт, пилинг 2-8-4. Пуск выполнен, ракета вышла.
Missile away. Lower the radar mast, we have an incoming torpedo. This torpedo is not well aimed. Now here is my missile, here's the ship. My missile should soon acquire and then turn around sharply and go straight for our little friend there. Yeah, there we go. Ship taken out.
Periscope. 3-0 meters.
Now I don't like this Valiant knowing where I am and me not knowing where it is. Okay, I know where the Valiant is now. 11 kilometers away. That's too far. That really is too far away. Oh no, it's only 5.7 kilometers. Going at a speed of 5 knots, so it's listening. Pinging, listening. I'm going below the layer. In fact, I am going very deep. He has a towed array though, so he can use his towed array to basically let it drop below the layer and then pick me up with that, but I don't think he has it deployed. Maybe it's damaged. Could be. And now he has lost me. So I'll begin to speed up and get closer. That's now the target. Now, because I went below the layer, I now also lost contact to the Valiant. Another torpedo incoming. Let's get out of the way. I believe we will have to dodge some torpedoes here. My guess is that we are quite deep and these torpedoes are shallow. Yeah, there's one up there. You can barely see it. Yeah, they are indeed aimed shallow. We re-establish contact with the Valiant. He's pinging again. Yeah. We are not playing that game with him. If he's pinging, then I'm pinging. I want to know where he is. 2.9 kilometers. I want to get closer. So we will continue to run. But we'll zigzag, just to confuse the hell out of him. Where is he? He's very shallow. But I guess that's to be expected of a submarine with such a hole in it. And it looks like he fired another torpedo, the damn bastard. Yeah, but it's going to miss because I turned around.
Командир, маневр выполнен. Идем заданным курсом.
Okay. Still getting closer. Dodging his torpedoes. How many tubes does he have? 6 tubes. Six tubes for the Valiant. That's fine. 1.7 kilometers. I think we are almost in range to fire. A little bit more time compression here. 1.5 kilometers. That is now very important. I need to put on some speed. So that I can maintain my mobility. What is this torpedo doing? Did he set up a circle runner? Oh, that's dangerous, man. You might be picked up by your own torpedo here. Okay. I want to know if he shoots a torpedo going active. He knows where I am anyway. We are coming up nicely. I want to get above the layer so that my torpedo has the maximum chance to pick him up. He fired another torpedo, turning towards him. Cavitating, that's fine. We are above the layer. Torpedo away. Turning around. I think I just forced him towards his own torpedo. That's not very nice of me, is it? Will my torpedo pick him up? Yes or no? I mean, it should pick up the countermeasure. Yeah, there we go. And then, right after that, it should pick up him. Yeah, my torpedo is going for him. So who knows, maybe one torpedo will be actually enough to sink him. He dropped a countermeasure, but I don't think he's getting out of the way in time. So yeah, that torpedo is going straight back for him. He can't change the depth anymore. It seems that this is his problem right now. And now the torpedo is cutting into his turn. He also did lose some speed, I believe. No, he has his top speed again. What just happened? What are you... What is going on again? Okay, the torpedo is going back for the first countermeasure here, but he has attracted his own torpedo. So this can still become very interesting. I need to get the hell down there before one of those torpedoes picks up me. Because this back there, that's me. I'm way too close to this. I wanted to say torpedo has reacquired, but not really. His own torpedo though. His own torpedo is going for him. Yeah. No, God, this dude is so lucky. I cannot believe this. How many times did he barely, just by a meter or so, avoid the torpedo? But he can't go deep anymore. He's staying on the surface. That's all he seems to be able to do. And he will run out of countermeasures. And once he does that, well, then it's game over. But again, both torpedoes turned into the wrong direction. Picked up countermeasures instead of him. The usual stuff. Now this torpedo... it's coming from his left side, there it goes. But I think it will, yeah, a new countermeasure. With both torpedoes going for it. But as I said, this is fine, he will run out of countermeasures. I don't think he has many left. And once that happens, it's over. There's nothing he can do anymore. Okay, his own torpedo is turning into this direction and could now acquire the submarine, actually. Come on, yeah, there we go. His own torpedo has acquired. And is coming for him. Now, I think his own torpedoes are slow as hell. So, I don't think... it has that much of a chance to do something good here. But he has dropped another countermeasure. The torpedoes... his torpedo has run through the countermeasure and is back on him. If my torpedo will do the same depends on... no, it's going the wrong way, as usual. His torpedo is on him though. And it's getting closer. Now, I don't think that his torpedo has the speed to hit him. But it will put some pressure... oh, maybe it does. It went for another countermeasure. This is getting a little bit silly. And my torpedo is... of course, going into the wrong direction. Wow, once I'm finished with this 1968 campaign... I really have to play a modern campaign where I have wire-guided torpedoes and can simply steer them around these countermeasures. Yeah, this torpedo is turning the wrong way. They are stuck between these two countermeasures here. But I think he has run out. He isn't dropping anything anymore. So if that is indeed the case, then his own torpedo that is now turning around... no, it's going for the countermeasure. Don't mind me. I can't have that. Not now that we finally have him. Come on, I want to know where he is. Just don't tell me he managed to avoid the torpedoes, because then I'm gonna be really mad. No, he didn't. He's going to eat a torpedo. If they manage to acquire him. I don't know what's wrong right now. Torpedoes seem to be derping out a little bit. He might actually run away from the torpedoes. I cannot believe this. If he does actually evade these torpedoes, I don't know. That would be so hilariously stupid. Okay, my torpedo seems to be doing something weird. Turning away from him, of course. Yeah, sure. But he missed his chance. He's actually coming back towards my torpedoes instead of running away. And after they complete their turns here, they should pick him up. I said they should. Nah, not really. His one isn't picking him up. Maybe mine will. No, of course not. So that's another torpedo wasted on a target that is damaged but absolutely amazing at evading torpedoes. Let's actually see. He's turning back again, so maybe one of the torpedoes will pick him up after all. Maybe my torpedo, but I think my torpedo might actually be almost out of fuel. So I imagine my torpedo detonating just shortly after picking him up or something like that. No, my torpedo went deep. The torpedoes went deep. They are searching below because they got God damn it, I hate that one. Yeah, my torpedo just went boom. His torpedo is still in the water, but I need actually to fire another torpedo. Cannot believe this. I cannot believe this. He evaded two torpedoes. Damaged. Oh boy. I'll get him now. I'll get you this time. You are slowing down. I know you will launch, but I'll still get you. I'm coming up for you. I'm coming up above the layer and I'm shooting a torpedo at you. Turn around. Yeah, he fired. I expected that. Slow down, come on. This mission has again been... The 1968 campaigns can be really frustrating, and I think he's actually gonna get out of the way again. Please don't. Oh, you... dirty... bastard. So we both missed. That's fine. That's absolutely fine. Let's dance. Okay. He's above me.
Командир, моя глубина 180 метров.
I'm now behind you. Now this is gonna be a hit. There we go. This has again been one hell of a fight. Nice, I have three torpedoes remaining, so I can go back to port again. Wow, I cannot go back to port after every fight. I'm using way too many torpedoes. There we go. He's gone. He's finally gone. Okay. The oil tanker, he's gone. Now let's just use time compression until the... Thank you. Let's just go this way until the torpedoes are out of steam. And then we can leave the combat area and go back to port again. I cannot believe this. One engagement has used up 15 torpedoes. 15. And one missile. It is a little bit frustrating how many torpedoes I need to sink one target sometimes, especially submarines. Okay, I think we got it. Oh, hi there. Oh, it's getting shallow. Okay. Leave the combat area. Yeah, the US fleet oil tanker escaped. We got everything else. Good job. Keep up the mission. I don't think I will. Let's go back to port to refit. Okay, welcome back. Now we have been 60 days at war. The war is going on for 2 months already. And I don't know. I really don't. This is... So far, this is really... Let's say mixed success. I want to have more of these torpedoes. How many? 4, 5, 6. And I can take... Two, three, four. And maybe 5, or should I take another wake homing torpedo? I think for now I might take another wake homing torpedo, since these torpedoes have proven to be supremely useful. Or should I take something else? I need one missile. Having 4 of these, I think that is enough. I'd rather have one of these extra, to be honest. Yeah, let's use that. Let's use this configuration here. Okay. 13 hours in port. 13 hours in port is fine. Okay then. This has been enough for this episode. It has again been a long one, and next time we will again sail into the Greenland Sea and find something to sink that maybe doesn't require this much effort, but we'll see. Thank you very much for your time, and if any of you has any suggestions for me on how to have an easier time at this, then please feel free to write them into the comments. But for now, thank you, and we'll see each other next week. Have a nice week. Goodbye.